Welcome to 19 Washington Square North, which is the home of NYU Abu Dhabi in New York. Every year we host a series of rotating exhibitions in this space, and we're fortunate enough for you to be at the opening of Faig Ahmed's Black Sheep, which includes three carpets that were completed this year. So these are newly completed works that you're able to view here. So we're very excited to be able to put on this show. We also have a wonderful artist talk that I'd like to introduce you to our two speakers. Our first is Nina Levent, who is going to be conducting the interview talk with Faig. Nina is CEO of Sapar Contemporary Art. Prior to taking on this current role, Dr. Levent spent 14 years as executive director of Art Beyond Sight, whose mission is to make art, art history, and visual culture accessible to people who are blind or visually impaired. There, Dr. Levent collaborated with numerous museums on programs to educate staff on ways to better serve people with disabilities. A year and a half ago, she co-founded Sapar Art Gallery, which not only represents artists from around the world, but also serves as an incubator that sponsors residencies and group shows. Dr. Levent holds a PhD from the Humboldt University in Berlin in art history and cultural history, and is co-author of the 2014 book, Multisensory Museum, Cross-Disciplinary Perspectives on Touch, Sound, Smell, Memory, and Space. And our main attraction, Faig Ahmed. Faig is a 2004 graduate of the sculpture faculty at the Azerbaijan State Academy of Fine Art in Azerbaijan's capital of Baku. Ahmed is well known for his carpets, sculptures, videos, and installations that have been exhibited at major art centers around the world, including London, Paris, Berlin, New York, Dubai, Moscow, and Hong Kong. He has been featured in solo exhibitions and two Venice Biennales. The first was in 2007, where he represented Azerbaijan in the nation's first pavilion, and again in 2013 as part of the show Love Me, Love Me Not. He was also a shortlist nominee for the Victoria and Albert's prestigious Jamil Prize, which is an international award for contemporary art and design that draws inspiration from Islamic traditions. His works are part of collections of the Los Angeles County Museum and Seattle Art Museum, as well as private collections of the Jamil Foundation in London, the Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan bin Khalifa Al Nahyan collection in the UAE, among many others. Points of Perception at the Museo d'Arte Contemporanea di Roma was Ahmed's first solo museum exhibition, which recently closed and included installations, video work that was specially created for the space. So without further ado, I'm going to turn the event over to our speakers. So thank you.
We could just begin a conversation. The way Faig and I thought about it is that we'll build it as a conversation, essentially looking chronologically at his body of work. And I thought the place to begin, Faig, is maybe the thing that's not very obvious to people who know your work, and that's the fact that you're a sculptor by training. And if you could sort of talk a little bit about what was it like to become a sculptor in this Azerbaijan in the 1990s, you know, mid to late 1990s, what were your formative years like?
So, I think actually, I'm an artist, first of all, but not because I have an education of art, but because I was born as an artist. So, okay. So, about my education and why I decided to be an artist. So it was actually, I think it wasn't just actually because I was born as an artist. So it was part of my character, it was part of my personality. So I've chosen only one education institution in Azerbaijan, is an art academy. I choose the sculpture faculty because I was really interested in sculpture and in written forms and in visualized thoughts. So it was the best solution of or best way to speak with the girl with this language of art. So 90s was actually a very hard time in this country. So as many of you maybe know that it was a time when USSR was separated and Azerbaijan was a part of the USSR, and so I was in the country, was just born and just start to establish, just start to begin, and then just start to be in a country. So that's why I lived in the period of very like big change. So.
Actually, I didn't plan on asking this question, but it's sort of, I asked you about your training, and you said I was born an artist, and when did you know?
Yeah, so...
What made you think? I mean, I know we sort of talked about this before, but yeah. What is it like to be born an artist?
I think just, until now I don't know what it is, actually. Now I just don't understand what it's like to be an artist. Actually, I think it's just a state of mind, just state of character, or just to feel freedom in everything, so just... You know, it's not a job, it's not a career or something.
It's a calling.
It's just a way of living, a way of thinking. So, because when you are an artist, you are always like looking at everything and or thinking about everything in a different way. So you're always trying to understand it's like that maybe it's like a even it's like a normal things in a different way. So that's why it's sometimes it's very hard to explain, to choose the material, to choose themes, subjects for that. So it's kind of way to explore yourself first of all. Like it's not about to make something or to speak about something. It's about exploring. It's more about exploring.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Leaves are a few slides.
Yeah, you can see that. I was a sculptor and it was very dirty works, but you see, like it's very hard to be an artist in Azerbaijan at that time. It was. So because it was very conservative school, and it was a very conservative in a way, because it was the old USSR school with a all these figurative sculptures, so I was like all this. I feel like it's something wrong here. Like I didn't know anything about what's going on in the art world. So we didn't have any internet, so we didn't have any books. What's going on in contemporary art? So I had never heard like even what is contemporary art, like what contemporary art is. So and when I start to learn and when I start to travel or when I get some books and when I start to learn English to read some. Books, not what we had in our university or academy. So I start to learn, I start to research different materials. So as well as was interesting with the rule and with the construction and deconstruction. It's actually came, but it's like this kind of like subjects came from my childhood when I was interesting to.
It takes things apart.
Everything. So actually, my first thing when I took apart was carpet. Actually, so I again came back to the carpet. So I just cut out like carpets, my old grandmother's carpet in our house, and my parents was very angry, but they didn't punish me. But they was very angry.
They encouraged you.
50 years old carpet from my grandfather.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, I was not a boy, but you know, I was interested because it was easy. Like it's like a game. Like I didn't understand why I can take this one and put here because it's not in the place. So, you know, and so I just kind of, I was alone. Actually, my grandmother was at home. So and so she just actually like. My parents thought that they have to care about me, but she just watched a movie or something on the TV, so I just cut off all carpets. So for sure it was very hard to bring them all again, so they just threw it. So, yeah, and actually I can say it's influenced, like this like experience influenced me to be an artist. It's just, like, it just was like, it being me, like it was just something, just part of me. And you see, like, and I'm doing it, but in a professional way too. So I'm just throwing carpets through them. So, and actually this is like photo from one of my studio, because I always change my studios. I don't like to stay in one place for a long time. Like always changing my places, my place of living, my place of working, and thanks God I'm not changing my friends. And it's actually was one of the materials that I used in my like as experiment. It was just a piece of leaves, like lives. It was moss.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, and sorry for my English. If something you didn't understand, so we can always ask. And it's open conversation actually. If you will have a question, so you can always ask. So we are just it's not a lecture. It's just talk. So we are really talking to each other. So actually, it was I just put this like hearts. So because it just was interesting in that how a heart is like something with being themselves. So as you know, like heart muscles, they don't need nerves for beating. So they beating themselves. So that was interesting. But I took them and I just linked them with the wires and tried to connect it with the music. And to understand how it's influenced to the heart beating and how it's working together. So it's not just different experiments what I did, and it's one of the experiments I did.
What kind of music?
So it was a mugam. It's Azerbaijan national music, not only Azerbaijan. So it's very famous type of the music in all these areas, starting from Central Asia to North Africa. So probably it was this kind of music was born in Persia. But in Azerbaijan, it's like how Azerbaijan musicians say it, it's Azerbaijan, it's blumt. So it was, is it right to say the blumt?
Mm-hmm.
Right. It became some very, very strong musician, like musical compositions. So there are seven mugams, so different types of mugams. So, and it's very strange music because. So what I did, like I just like in like, is that right? So it's invert the music. Like if you will listen the music from the end to the start, so you will see, like you will listen, you will hear the same type of the music. It's not changed as a language. So yeah, it just was experiment. I didn't went deep of this kind of things. So it just was something that I just did. It's okay. It's technical things. So and actually, it's very not only for me. Like it's actually it's for everybody who working with a creative, who using creative in their like profession in their life. It's very important to make an experiment, and it's not necessary to experimenting with your material, with your like even concepts. I don't know how to, like any materials what you're using. Like abstract way. So it's very important to use a different experiments in your life, just to understand how everything working, because it's just something that we have to know. It's not because we are human, it's just because we can think. And
What was the point? What I wanted to ask you is at some point you engaged with the carpet, you decided this is going to be a canvas.
Yeah.
What was the
propose?
Yeah.
What was the moment?
What
actually not was it just an enlightenment moment, like it's not was something like where I just came to the room and said, oh no, this is my like as many of the artists. So you can see that here was the first experimental. So actually this photo is like from the one of the like typical Soviet Union's Soviet periods rooms, and actually these kind of rooms you can see, like you can find easily even now in Azerbaijan when everything has changed, but the carpet still was in the rooms. So it was kind of it's a fake symbol of richness, because actually the carpet always was produced by the kings or dynasties, by by the rich people, or it was made by the, produced by for the rich people. So the blooming of the, or like you can say like blooming, this the carpet period, like it was a 100, like it was a in the 15th 16th century, when Safavids was in the Persian, the Safavids, it was dynasty in the Persian empires. So and so that was a period of when the carpet became a symbol of riches. So and that's why like it's in Soviets, the men of the Soviets or in Azerbaijan's the apartment you can always you can find this kind of carpet, what was a symbol of the this kind of richness. But all this carpet was made by machine, so it was very cheap material with a cheap quality, and so it was kind of something that like it's they have a double they this kind of like this carpet, they have a double meaning for me. The one is that it was a part of tradition, what like me as a young person, like I was, I don't know, 20 or something, I was against for any kind of tradition, like as many of us. So it was this period when he was against of everything. So and I was against of any kind of tradition, because Azerbaijan is a very traditional country, but now it became for much modern for sure. Everything is changing. So but that period was very, very traditional, like very conservative society with a traditional way of thinking. And the carpet was for me was a symbol of this. So the carpet was a structure what's never changed. So because I just saw the carpet in my, as I said, like it's my grandmother's room, in our room, like in every apartment, our friends. So it was a kind of like something kept coming from the past, and so that's why it was something like what was a kind of red textile for the ox. Yeah. So that's why it was interesting. So and I started to work when the carpets start to think how it can they can be destroyed the way that not will touch the people. Like I mean, it's have to touch the people, but not touch the people. Like to not to touch the to the emotions. Let's say like or. It can touch the emotion, but they can say anything. So I will explain what I mean. For example, like if the artist, for example, or somebody like saying something about religion, we can always say like it's right or not. So you can, if you're saying something against of religion, it's always discussable. But when you're doing something with a, it's not discussable, because the carpet is not discussable stuff. So it's something what's coming very ancient time, and it's not related with a religion. It's not even related directly with the tradition. So actually, so that's why I thought like if I will do something, some destruction with the carpet, there will be something interesting. So and I will see the experiment and the effect of the how it will affect to the people and how it will affect to the people who will see that. So because it was kind of very, very significant symbol of the of society's structure, let's say.
Mm-hmm.
But now I understand that. But at that time I was just, young, and I was just starting to.
You really had an antagonistic relationship with the carpet. It's not like, it's,
yeah.
You know, this is sort of.
Yeah, it was kind of my enemy, actually. No,
yeah.
But it's not that because I like hate something or something. It was just my nature, I think. So
mm-hmm.
I just choose the carpet as a symbol for me, and it was strong symbol. So that's why I just choose it, because I never, because I feel that I was strong, but it's. For sure, it's just like, when your age is coming, you're feeling that you are just a human, and not, you don't have as much power as you thought.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody in 16 thinking like, I can like change the world, and so this is actually the photo from the, actually this video from the, you don't mind, so we can, it's just for information how it's, everything's working. So it's typical.
Söyledik aslında bu işimiz yok.
Village, how this actually it's most of the carpets made by women.
So this is how they are social carpets.
Actually all carpets.
Yes, yes. Ama
and you know, like they doing it from the 8 of the morning to the 10 of the night. So, all day they work on the
whole.
So it's another view just to see that how it's technical, it's very hard to make actually. And it's very interesting that it's like when I start to looking for, like, you know, I made sketches. I said, okay, I'm gonna do the carpets. So I just made my sketches on the computer, and then just start to looking for the different you know, the villages for to just to realize my carpets and my ideas. And most of them said no. Like, even I was kicked off from the one of the villages. And they said, like, you are teasing on our tradition, what you're doing. So, and I feel like it's everybody against me, and it's even giving me more power to produce my thoughts, my ideas. So, and at the end of the day, so one of the houses, like, who just, like, it was kind of exactly a house with the women's and daughters, mother, they all work on the carpet. So they start to do one of the carpet, and they didn't understand why they're doing it, just because I'm paying them for this. So they said, okay, like, we will do that, but never, don't say to anybody that we did that, because it's like, you know, it was kind of like shame, yeah. And you know, like, when I start to work, and I start to understand that it was very hard work, like, it was very hard work, and villages was even more conservative than state, because it was very close societies. They never went out from their village, and they only work on the work. They, what they had is, it was a carpet, and they didn't do anything, and it was very hard to connect with them, because I was, the first 2 years I was connect through their brothers, husbands, and so, because I can speak with a woman, and but now it's okay, so they all know me. Yeah, and but I start to understand it's not easy. How I thought, like, before I thought it's like, oh, it's just carpet, like, we can cut it, or can we do it like this and that. So, but as much as I start to work with them, I understood that it's not so easy. Like, it's not so easy to be and live there. I didn't understand how they're living there, and I thought, like, I was thinking that maybe this kind of work will also affect today's small society. And I start to experiment with this small society. There was like about 50 people in the village, and I start to experiment with this village to just speak with them, like, about, like, what do you think about this kind of traditional, like, or maybe it's better if I will speak with your, for example, if you're with your sisters. No, what are you saying? No, it's okay. Like, I will start to pushing them a little bit to the boundaries, to a little bit change, but it was like very hard actually. And also, like, I thought I can do it in 1 year, but it took years to do that. Yeah. But now I think I feel the effect of this, and I'm now doing the movies about how something changed. Not because my carpets, actually, it's all the times changing. Everything's changing around. Like, most of them, they have a connected with the internet, and they have like iPhones and other devices for connecting with the world. But actually, watching the stupid movies, but it's okay. Like, it's okay anyway. Like, it's, that will help. So that was the first step when I started, and just so I just started to do, like, different type of the works, and actually it was one of the first work. So it was called Fluid of Yellow Weight. Yeah. So why yellow? So I was actually parallel with the carpet, that was interesting with the different spiritual knowledge, we can say like that, if I can say like that. So the one of them was Buddhism at that time, and I was interested in Buddhism, and the yellow was symbol of, the yellow in Buddhism is symbol of death, but death of your mind, death of you as a ego, death of your ego, like it's better to say it. And it was a kind of renewing yourself, and it was a kind of death of your order, everything you have, the death of old of you, and renew you. So it was like first work, just renew everything. So just renew all what we had. But actually, Azerbaijan has a very huge story of different, like, the huge story of tradition, huge story of different layers of the cultures. And so it was a very to say it's in English. Even I don't know how to say it in my language, okay?
No, finish your
thought. Ну, это как бы было слишком много на себя брал. То есть, как бы, да, я слишком много на себя брал.
Dairy.
Думаю это.
Dairy.
It was, yeah, I think that's the meaning of it, that it was too daring considering that Azerbaijan already had all of this sort of mix of tradition as it is.
Yes, exactly, yes. So it's another work, it's called Outflow. It was it's one of the typical work when I did at that time. It was just, you know, like I always, like I, the now I understand that I always keep the some part of the carpet always like as it was, and other ones was like totally destroyed. This also was a symbol of the past and something. It's not about new, or it's not about now or future. It was just some kind of movement or some kind of changing. Because when we speak about changing, it's always moving. And the движение is moving. The moving is always happening now. It can happen in the future or the past. So it's something happened now. So it's just that something happened now. What's going on now is something what we can call now and here. Yeah. In the present. Yeah. When I start to work with the carpet, there's the most of the carpet weavers, they need a kind of mapping for the carpet. So you can just come to say like, do me like, just can you do this carpet? No, they need a kind of paper. So I've used this. It's very hard to know the move, huh? Yeah, the engineering paper to draw the carpet dot by dot exactly. It's like very pity that I didn't bring it. So, but it's exactly like a
you
like
map out the knots.
Yeah, like by the knots. So, and they can see, actually we saw it in the one of the videos. So they just need they just have this kind of roll of the paper, and yeah. So and it was very similar with how the image. Like in modern image building right now, it's not building by the pixels. So we can do it in another way. So the pixels are the best way to build the pictures in the computer, like or in the digital way. So as it was before. So if you later will come to any carpet, you will see that all these knots, it's exactly like a pixel. So and with this pixel, we can build everything. So it's given a big opportunity to do what I want with this material. It was very old material. So later I will tell her about how old it was, and so that's why it was a kind of appreciation of the carpet. So the pixel, pixel actually it's a symbol of now, like symbol of present times. But actually it was used many times, thousands of years ago. So I mean, people understood that it's best way to build any kind of image. So it's another work. It was called like liquid. It was a time when I feel unstable. So you can see it here. And it's not only me. The whole region is always in unstable position. So because it's everything you can see like in this region is very stable. It's look like a very traditional. It's very structured and it's everything plus minus understandable. But same time, it can fall anytime, and this is how, like very strong culture, very strong structure can fall, and it can fall on the floor, and it can became of. No, we can say it's nothing, but it's something.
It becomes something else.
Yeah, something else, which
morphs.
Yeah, it's a morph. It's more yeah, because the same time it can keep the same lines and the same. The colors and the same even, you know, like, because I'm always using the carpet as it's like, all works is handmade, all works is dyed, like naturally dyed, and all works is done by how it was like, you know, thousands and hundreds of years ago. And so that's why it was interesting to see this, keep the same material. It's because I give myself some kind of shape. And it was a kind of okay, I'll forget this word. anyway, like I, it's kind of, it was kind of shape for myself, and so I started to work in this material shape and understood how deep I can go. It was kind of quite.
This is a very successful
situation. So I also experimented with a different material as a sculpture. So it was a connection of the wood or plastic sculptures. So it was, for example, like, you know, if you saw the how the if you will cut a kind of piece of wood. So you'll see these lines, how the lines going through this wood. So it was same, it's kind of deepness of the carpet. So it's another one, it's installation. I did it in one of the art space in Baku. The first one was in Baku, and another one I did in Venice. So it was kind of embroidered on the wall. So it was exactly embroidered on the wall. So I just make a lot of holes in the wall by the some kind of system. And I just embroidered the walls with a silk or woolen threads, but half of them that was destroyed. But it's not exactly destroyed. I mean, you can say that it's destroyed or it's built at that time. So it's kind of like something between of this tension.
Between creation and destruction.
Yeah, just yeah. Creation and destruction. Yeah. That's actually interesting. I came the idea that this carpet became a symbol of structure, which is very interesting. And same time, everything is structured in our life, our mind, our way of thinking, our way of living. Because like we're waking up in the morning, we're going to work and we're doing our stuff, we're meeting with the people, with our friends on Saturday and Friday. So we have a structure in our life. But sometimes when chaos comes to our structure, it's immediately changing our life. It's immediately influence, and we can feel this moment. Actually, the artist calling this moment is
inspiration.
Yeah, inspiration. I forget. I'm an artist. I forget. Inspiration. So, yes, this is the moment of inspiration. Inspiration is chaos. Like when it's not when you know what to do. It's moment when you don't know what to do. Actually, it's kind of like just a pure energy, and you can feel this energy and. After it became a structure. So the carpet was kind of something when you can destroy something and it became a structure, but later it's
over. So I wanted to circle back to that idea of carpet being an information system, being a kind of, and talk to you a little bit about, you have a practice and then you have a research that you're interested in as philosophically or artistically. And so I wanted you to speak a little bit about your interest in religion, religious rituals, common origins of religion, cultural practices and their, you know, possibly common origins, as well as language and, you know, ancient languages, really, really sort of first human languages that are and ancient human writings.
Yeah, actually, I was interested in that, in this kind of language. So it's why I started to research the languages, because I was interested in religion, and especially in old Indian religions. So it's a big system of the books, let's say, like knowledge, which call them Vedas. Veda mean knowledge, and so it's not the one book, and it's coming from the, I don't know, 5, 10, or 15,000 years ago. So it's, they're not exactly time period when the most of the scientists, like, they talking about the time. So that's why the first language what I started to learn is was Sanskrit. So I just understood that it's not enough to get knowledge in just in English or another, not yet, the translation of the. So another language was Arab language. So I just started to use them. I started to learn researching and to learn this language. But Sanskrit was much interesting. So because it was much ancient. So and. There's most of the symbols was very interesting because they was related with exactly letters, but it mean also like some kind of long thoughts, let's say, like some kind of thing. And I was research for, and I found the symbols in the carpet. And I came through this carpet, which was found in Central Asia, it's one of the old, not one, it's the oldest carpet weaved like this, for example, or this. In this way, I mean, this technology, it was found 2,500 years ago in the Central Asia, called the place called Tazarik. And so it's quite old, actually. And I found that it didn't change, nothing changed. You can find the same type of the carpet right now, and maybe some images, maybe some colors, but in general, everything was the same. And that shocked me, because everything has changed from that time. Like, architecture, like the dresses, like thinking, like technologies, but carpets not. Yeah, because it was kind of, and I thought maybe it was a kind of knowledge there. So, and I started to learn what kind of language was a carpet language, and I came to another interesting thing. It was a runes. So I just started to compare two kind of runes, because one of the runes was found, like one type of the runes was found again in Central Asia, starting from China till the Caspian Sea. So about like in this area, it's called Orkhon Yenisei Napisi.
Writings,
yeah, petroglyphs, yeah. And it was a very, very. And I compared it with the Scandinavian runes, which was absolutely, the most of them was absolutely similar. For example, you can see that, for example, this symbol and this one. Where is this? Yeah, this one. It's actually the same symbol, but it's found. This is exactly the Scandinavian runes. But this one was found in Central Asia. So, and the both of them mean same, like this one is T, but same time this one is also mean T. But also you can read it for, like in other, so it can became also the symbol. So it's not a letter as we understand, like T is T, it's always there, right? But I mean, this kind of symbol, the runes was used also like as a symbol of something else, like it's can, you can, if you're changing the letters, you can read it in another way. So, and I found that most of the, actually you can see it later in this carpet, the most of this, you know, some symbols there. So it's actually one of the oldest design in this region. So later we can all look at this carpet. So I understand that there was some kind of knowledge, and one of the way to understand, to research of this knowledge and to understand how I can read it, it's not was like, because I didn't find any books about, there was a lot of books about carpet, about rooms, about all this, like scripts and about the symbols, but exactly how it was used in the carpet and why it was like, was in the carpet exactly. I can understand, like it was just a kind of symbol, the girls can just put it because they saw it somewhere. It's also like, can be happened in the past, but anyway, like, I understood that it's, there's some kind of system of the reading of this book, this kind of text, let's say. So, and then just kind of, again, as you see.
Kind of another carpet.
To understand how the different layers to see it in 3D, maybe probably it will work in 3D. Maybe it's kind of the sketch of or layout of some kind of machine or some kind of like kind of type of that I don't know, like maybe structure. Because why it's exactly like this? Maybe we can, if we'll look in the 3D, so we'll see something else. So.
This is an installation,
exactly, yes. One of them was out, and one of them, like, death. Like, it was like exactly the hole in the wall, and all these details was, like layers they went inside of the wall. And, so this is another experiment, when I just took one of the symbol on the carpet, the make 3D in the special softwares, but keep the same proportion and same, the proportion of the symbol, but make it 3D, and again applied it to the carpet, but it was weaved like this too, and it became something else. It became something like not exactly this symbol, like something what was absolutely alien. It looked alien in the carpet, but you can see it's looking something not exactly carpet, but symbol there is from carpet, and it's all flat and it's ribbed like carpet. But at the same time, we don't understand like why they are together and make some kind of tension in our mind to keep them together. So, but it all was experiment. It was all like to way to understand in different way how the language how the symbol can be read. Maybe it's a little bit strange way to do it. Like some can say you can just read the books about that. Why you doing this?
So that actually circles back on why we have this more. I mean, you spoke a little bit about the language, but I was wondering if you could speak about the sort of the ritual, the your interest in ritualistic practices or cultural practices or religious practices, you know, metaphysical practices, whatever you call them, that are evolved around objects such as carpet.
Yeah, it was actually after when I didn't find anything in symbols. So, no, I'm kidding, actually. No, I found something, but it's something what I can explain, because it bring me to the something deeper than just knowledge, like just something can be explained in the text or in the books. Mm-hmm. So I was always, like as I said, like I was always interested in the spiritual practice, and I actually tried a lot of religion. I mean, I really tried. I've been in religion. I've been Baptist for a long time. I've been a Bhakti, which means like Krishnaid, like it's Indian who believes the Krishna is God. So, because it was the only way to understand how this religion works. Yes, because I was looking for a truth. I was looking for a God, and God changed. Like way of like in this way God always changed, and sometimes it became concept and sometimes it became something in my heart, sometimes it became something around the people, and I became atheist in some of time of my life. Now I became in another way of the understanding of this very deep world, like God. And I was interested in Buddhism because it was one of the spiritual and one of the effective way of understanding God or truth, because it was something which they give you practice, like it's you can touch it, like it's not something somebody speaking about something.
Mm-hmm. It's experiential.
Yes, it's experiential. Like you can do something with yourself, because I don't have anything mm-hmm. except myself. So I have books, I have knowledge, but if I can try it, so it's not working. So, and I was interested in the Buddhism, and I found this this is mandalas, which Buddhist monks doing in some times of the year, and it's different schools doing it in different time. So, and what one of the interesting things, so you can read it, it's just doing that because there's some kind of protection or something like that, but it's mean much deeper. When my guru of Buddhist guru, he explained me that it's way of going through your subconsciousness or you can read it through your.
You're diving in.
Yes, you can dive in. How? It's then I link it with. I mean, it wasn't like something about my work or it's about my art life. So it wasn't just linked with my work in this way, when I found the same thing in the carpet. So then I understood carpet, and it was time when I changed all my way of thinking or about carpet. That was time when I went to myself. It was time actually when I started to travel in India and all the Asia, in Sri Lanka, Thailand, and Malaysia. So all this country I was traveled, and I found a lot of interesting societies and just interesting knowledge and interesting practice. And I started to practice with myself, and there was a very beautiful the words of one of the Sufi. He said, when you're traveling outside, you have to same time you have to travel inside. So it's easy words, but it's very hard to do that because when we're getting information from outside, we're not eating this information, it's hurting us. So we have to always go inside. And it was time when I just did it, same thing. It's affected my works for sure because it affects all my life. I didn't work for a long time and I started to work again when I exactly put to, I made my my boundaries, my boundaries is even smaller. So I didn't touch to cut like to the perimeter of the carpet. I just did everything inside. It's kind of something was blowing in the carpet. So and it was kind of it's giving even smaller
canvas
to work. But it was deeper. So I went deep of this. I went deep of this. So and I understood that it's deeper. It's deeper than I thought. And so they just did it in this series.
So this series always has a very stable water and this kind of
yes.
morphing inside.
Exactly, yeah. And because I started to do very strong practice at that time when I was... Sorry, it's time I have to...
It's practice.
It's practice time. yeah, it was a time when I just... when I did a lot of practice. And practice needed a very exact time for that
framework,
it's kind of framework. Yes, you have to work on yourself because I always was living a chaotic life. So as an artist, I was traveled all my life. I was just in a different like place. And sometimes I just waking up like this morning. I just where I am. I don't know which city I am. So I didn't understand where I am. And but that was time exactly when I understood because it was time when I understood that. I'm deeper, much deeper than this space. That's not because me, like it's all the humanity is like that. And all other people is like they have this deepness, even maybe deeper than I think. So it's affected my works for sure. And I was like, and there was a different works. For example, this one was when you're going inside you, but you're always finding the same thing. You're thinking that we are changing inside, but we are always finding the same thing, and we're going deeper and deeper till the wind. We will find shunya. Shunya means nothing. Nothing. So it's only because when we're cutting off our body, it's not mine. Like it's just something with changing. My thoughts, like it's always changing. Like now, like from in 1 hour, we will change our thoughts. We'll change our emotions. Somebody like get some message. Somebody can get some new thoughts, some new ideas. Like if we even compare in 10 years of our life, it's a lot of things changing around us. But who we are, like our emotions change, thoughts, our wishes, our fear, everything change. But what is not change? Ourself. What it is? So it's easy, but it's not easy. Like if body is not me, if everything is changing around me, if emotion is not me, if thoughts not me, if. Like, you know, I'm not speaking even about...
How far does it go?
Shunya. But it was very dangerous because sometimes I fall, like I was, you know, for like after this practice, I feel like I'm apart. So this work actually was, you know, I did something I feel like dangerous because I did some of them without guru and it was very dangerous practice when you're doing something like you can just not because you can get crazy it's just simple thing what can happen with you but because you never can take you again apart because when you're slide like slayani with the
when you sort of unpack the layers
so you will maybe if you will even it's like a Lego you know like when you're just parting everything you can put it again maybe in the same way.
They do look like meteorites on the loose or something, some spatial object.
It's inner meteorites.
Yeah.
It's not what we are thinking, so it's awesome.
So I wanted you to talk, I'll take questions after this, but it always surprises me how the talk of this, about this work goes into this current scientific research. And then I think that will pay up a lot.
Yeah. Actually, yes, it's actually was the time when I thought maybe I because I came to the one point when I understood exactly of my boundaries, like my real of human boundaries, let's say.
Limitations.
Because limitations, yeah. Yeah, it's even better, it's the way I'm using this word. And why? Because even when you're going through yourself, when you're going through your thoughts, through your consciousness, and you jumping and flying in your subconsciousness, you're coming to the some point when you just founding some kind of structure. And even chaos at this time became something structural. Like it was a time, like it was a, that work is about it's contained three things. It's a spiritual way of understanding the world, scientific understanding of the world, and and art. No, because the art is different type of the explaining of the world. It's absolutely free. Like there, it's everything is free in art. So you don't have a. So yes, we have a history in art, but it's not necessary to know history or to learn something to be an artist. Because to be in a scientist, you have to learn the formals and all this, you know, like. Oh, you had to read all this book to be a gymnast. That's why I didn't became a, you know, scientist. But I always was interested in what was this work is contained. So I also read I was interested in quantum physics, and till now I'm reading all this news about the quantum physics. It's very interesting. It's very interesting. The way of explaining it's very interesting to understand the reality, because physics came to one of the interesting thing is like when the reality is double and we deciding observer, so there the problem of observer, don't observer, it's mean we deciding how reality have to be, because so there was a the letter you can see maybe in internet, so it's calling the experiment with the experiment, so okay, later maybe I will find. Yeah, and that's what experiment was with the to understand which is wave is like wave is a vishishtvo is
a, is it a substance?
It's substance, yes, or wave. So because the wave and substance they work in a different way. The final of experiment was very interesting, because they didn't find any solution of it, because in one time it was a wave, in other words it was substance, and they didn't understand why. It was exactly experiment of physics with exactly tools, with exactly, you know, rules, and but they didn't find exactly, so that it was kind of boundaries of knowledge. It was kind of boundaries when we have to go through ourselves to understand it, because they didn't know that, because we are observers. We're deciding how matter have to be, how reality have to be. And it's mean when structure became a chaos, it's again became a structure. It's immediately became a structure. Because, for example, like we're saying, if they're structured, they have to be chaos. It's kind of two things always mirroring themselves. So as a carpet, actually, like it's something when nothing exists without anything. Like it's like man and woman, black and white. We have to understand everything in the contrast. It's like how the plus and minus in electricity working in the house. Like how we don't understand what is dark without white, without light, and so everything working this way. And there actually a lot of ways. In, for example, in physics, so there are, for example, 40. One of the theories saying like there are 40 realities, and they always doubling themselves. And which means there are no chaos. Like chaos is kind of just concept. It's like a nothing, and it's not exist. It was the best knowledge where I came at this time, when I understand that there are some borders, but I can go through this. And that word borders was myself. And I was happy that I found some answer, yes, explanation, and it was like another way. I was sad because I found borders of myself.
We can continue, but I said maybe we should take a few questions. Do we have any? No?
Let's continue.
Carry on. So off the question of borders and another, you've just arrived to this to the slide and the shamanic practice.
Yeah, this is actually very interesting. Image. It's this image from this is embroidery. It's from Peru. It's from Peru. One of the tribe called Shi people. It's very interesting, actually. Tribes. So they have a shamans which drinking ayahuasca. Maybe most of them heard about this. So it's psychedelic, which absolutely it's very one of the strongest psychedelics in the world. Actually, it's can be it's even stronger than mushrooms, it's stronger than the peyote, it's stronger than mescaline, which is peyote, and others. So why are they doing this? So it was kind of prep, but they're not just doing it for fun. So they're doing it for practice, and they're doing it actually once a year, and it's kind of practice for go through yourself to touch that borders, what we talk about. So it's kind of this borders always, as they explain, it's always looking as a kind of structure. So if somebody did some kind of this kind of like spiritual practice, or they did this kind of the psychedelic, they can understand what it means. So it's
what is the drawings called? What is it called? What is this?
It's calling the structure of the universe.
Structure.
It's just end of the universe, but it's just very complicated language where they're calling like end or it's something which mean your it can mean your own end or end of the universe. So they're like something which can and they and actually when they're coming back from this trip, they doing this embroidery where they're explaining the kind of again knowledge what can be explained not by words but by the kind of this kind of knowledge. So and it's something when you have to be there to understand what it is. And the same kind of things was used by shamans in Siberia, for example. They're using this kind of drums for going as it's another way to go to this dip. It's not necessary to drink something or to eat some psychedelics. It's another way to go through your subconscious consciousness first, then subconsciousness, and then go even deeper. And actually, there another way that is our consciousness working very well. So that's why we're speaking. We're understanding each other, maybe not understanding sometimes, but consciousness, that subconsciousness, working in another way. It's there no language, there no way to explain everything in the way how we understand to understand. And so that's why they use it in another language for explaining the knowledge. So it's bring me to another spiritual and mystery, mystic way of explaining the world, the way of explaining the universe and in general everything. It was a Sufi philosophy. So it's quite deep philosophy, and you can't find information about that. I mean, you can find and you can read about the history of this way of philosophy, but it's in general it's always moving and always changing kind of philosophy, and always like it's always taking the new ideas from around, and at the same time it's keeping the own structure of practice. So and they have a great practice for like because they work on this all day, it's existed for like the hundreds of the years, and that's why they really work on it. They read write a lot of books about that, and So it was another.
Is that Konya?
It was Konya, yes. Exactly. So it's actually was of the one of the. It's calling the way of the school. So one of the schools is they call it dervish, like flying.
Mevlana.
Mevlana, yes. No, Mevlanas. So it's actually one of the schools of the dervish school. So it's bringing to another verse, which was, for example, these books. It was written by Arabic language, which means I. Like you can see it here. It's just a. It's just a.
One letter.
One letter. Like it's like you can read. They write it like this, but same. It's like I in English, like I. And I did this book. It was a handmade book with a handmade print. I did this book and I was read all this book myself. It was kind of absolutely and functional practice, like unfunctional thing. So because I didn't get any information, but it bring me to the point when I understood that everything is meaningless. So I mean, in general, everything is meaningless, but this is the meaning actually. That is, there's no meaning. And when you're just doing something rhythmic, it's actually all culture and all religion have this kind of practice. When, for example, when you're doing in Christianity with the beats, it's very popular in the Catholic Christians, or in Islam they're also using beats, and also the Buddhists using beats, and but most of the religion and shamans using beats, it's kind of giving your to your brain, you lying to your brain, you're making your brain stuck. Because our brain always the need always to get some new information, and it's always have to change. And it's not like, for example, nobody will just sit like this, just watch on the white wall and do nothing. It's our brain will get worried and say, do nothing, or we at least will think about something or will feel something. But when we're doing some kind of this premise, and another is I did this with the beats. There was a 9,099 beats, so I just choose for this. For this project, just word nine, letter number nine. So it just.
So this is part of the same installation.
Yeah, this part. So here I'm just doing this.
The length of the
phrase. Yeah, it's another work. It was just round carpet. There's another kind of practice when you're going around yourself, and so I just. I just make a two kind of two practice. It was one was the hurting when I walked with the oak's heart on my legs, which gave was one thing that I didn't face much. So it was a it just a part of the. Yes. When will be enough? I can say about this time. So I walk there till this heart get like nothing, and I was it was time when I just have to when I just.
When you start walking.
Yeah. But I stay without that, and it was between praying and getting hurt. So it's kind of like I make a tension in my brain. So because the one part is a body, so it's like it's hurting, and another is when you're praying, so you're going a little bit.
You're excellent.
Yes, and so it was a practice for feeling meat part of your like it's like harmony part of your between the pleasure and hurting. So this another verb is it's the most carpet. So it was just a symbol of the turning, symbol of the because the, actually all mosques like they face to the Mecca. So it's just a place in the Saudi Arabia, which is the holy place for the old Muslims, and they always when you pray they always face it there. So it was an installation which symbolized that it was a kind of it's called the wave when something come to you again. So which mean God come to you like God like you don't have to face to somewhere to find God. It's in you. Yeah.
It's actually has an interesting shadow play on the
background. Yeah, so in the background it looks also different because it was very like raw sculpted, raw structure was keep this all this part of the carpet, so it became a part in the as it was like it went up, it became a part, and and it's faced to you again when you're facing to this way, it's again coming back to you. It's being you praying to yourself and you looking for the God in yourself, and it's making kind of again a circle.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
You know what I didn't ask you? I didn't even think about this. Why did you call the exhibit Black Sheep?
Black Sheep. So the black sheep is because the old sheep is actually tell this story. So if there are black sheep in Azerbaijan, actually the white sheep is better than black. Why? Because you can always
dye
it. Yes, and so that's why if there are some black sheep, they're calling it bad. So they're trying to just sell it or just to sell it as a meat or something. So that's why it's something somebody's like who is always out of the
undesirable person.
Yes, out of society. But same time, it's not necessary because sometimes if the black sheep is running out, it's mean good luck. It's mean kind of that good luck. So he's going out of the society, but same time he became free, and it's kind of symbol of the freedom in this kind of tribe of the sheep.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Questions, comments, or shall we look at carpets together?
Shall we go through again?
Oh, yes.
Can you talk a little bit about how that carpet was constructed?
The last one? The big one?
No, that one.
This one? Oh, okay, sorry. Yeah, I didn't actually spoke about the... Yeah, okay.
So this long one?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Actually, it was it's just about two materials, and same time it's two different culture, version, yeah. When, for example, this one is wool, and this one is silk. And so why wool and silk? So wool came from the Kachemiki.
From nomads.
From nomad culture, from nomad tribes culture, and because they always do use the sheep for with themselves. I mean, they always travel, so that's why it's kind of like symbol, not symbol, but it's material of this nomad culture. And another is a Sintet culture, which was in this area. And all this area was mixed of two of these different cultures. And Iran and Azerbaijan, all these areas is a mix of two of these cultures. So one was a Turk speaker, Turkish speaker, let's say, which was nomads. And another was a Persian speakers or language was around the Persian languages. So, and it was a kind of mix of the two of these cultures. And my idea was that mix them together because they looking more, but they looking exact. So when you mixing both two of this knowledge of they have, you're getting something like Azerbaijan, my country, where I'm from. So because it's exactly the place where the old roads cross. So it's a place where you can find the different languages. Like there are like more than 25 languages in the same. It's a very small country actually. It's like a three New York maybe. Yeah. So and it wasn't just the idea to bring them together to understand how the two of this material can work together and how they can look and how they will merge with myself. Yeah.
Any other questions? So shall we go and look at carpets? Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.